new way of thinking about our nation's wilderness had been found. In fact, the fight to save Hetch Hetchy was transformed into a campaign to restore Hetch Hetchy. Decades after the valley was sunk and the country rallied to protect other national parks from the same fate, President Reagan's Secretary of the Interior, Donald Hodel, brought Hetch Hetchy to the forefront with a bold proposition for its restoration.
Well, sometime in 1986 or early 1987, we were struggling with the fact that there's tremendous overcrowding in Yosemite National Park. It's a million-acre park, but everybody wants to crowd into the same 5,400 acres, which is Yosemite Valley, because of the spectacular scenery. And somebody said to me, well, you know, there's another Yosemite Valley. I said, what are you talking about? And so then I learned the story of how this sister valley, Hetch Hetchy Valley, had been dammed up in the early 1900s, and it was now a reservoir.
Secretary Hodel ordered a preliminary study by the Bureau of Reclamation and was encouraged by what they had to say.
But we think it's entirely possible you could remove the dam, restore the valley, and provide water and power at least equal to what comes out of there now if you would just operate the river system in an appropriate fashion. In fact, we thought in the end the studies would show you could have more water if you took this dam out and operated the system properly. Some people raise the question, well, what about the electricity, and especially in light of the recent shortages of power in California and the like? Hetch Hetchy has a capacity of about 120,000 kilowatts. At the time I made the proposal, the California system had about 61 million kilowatts of capacity, so small that you can hardly find it. In fact, my recollection is that the dam was being used primarily for peaking capacity for San Francisco, which is an important usage, but is dwarfed by the availability of power from adjacent regions and new gas-fired power plants that have been built and the like. So this dam is just a tiny drop in the bucket of the power supply in the region.
With such promising information, Hodel took his case to Congress.
Ultimately, the Congress decided that it would prohibit us from spending any money doing the study that needed to be done. There needed to be this in-depth study of the operation of the water system and the power supply.
Which brings our story to today. Restore Hetch Hetchy, a nonprofit organization, was established, enrolling the dedication and expertise of naturalists, lawyers, engineers, public policy and finance experts, historians, artists, and dedicated supporters throughout the country to formally devise a plan for a win-win situation for both Hetch Hetchy and the city of San Francisco.
And the win-win situation is really finding ways of providing water and electrical energy for that which would be lost when Hetch Hetchy Reservoir became a valley again.
Some of our alternatives show that by enlarging local storage and conveyance capacity across the San Joaquin Valley, water supply reliability can be increased.
Well, water in California is almost the lifeblood of the state in many ways. We're really a semi-desert state. Hetch Hetchy, fortunately, is a very small component of the overall water system. It's only a couple hundred thousand acre feet of reservoir, a few hundred thousand, and compared to overall storage in the state, it's really very small. Fortunately, right downstream there's a much larger reservoir which can fill in much of the role that Hetch Hetchy plays, and with a few other engineering solutions we can avoid any adverse effect on our water system.
Right now, the entire Hetch Hetchy water system is in imminent need of major repairs to protect it from earthquakes and upgrade the water quality. This will cost the San Francisco Bay Area billions of dollars. Now is the time to plan for the removal of this dam.
Actually, in the Bay Area, there is very little wastewater reclamation going on. That is using water that would be dumped into the ocean after being treated for things like irrigation, industrial supply, and so on. Los Angeles is actually doing a much better job. We can do that. That would help with the water supply. Water conservation is really in its infancy in the Bay Area. There's a lot more that can be done. And it's probably possible to increase slightly the size of some of San Francisco's terminal reservoirs that are in the Bay Area to make up for the missing water. All of those things working together could really replace the Hetch Hetchy water supply.
Our neighbors in Los Angeles experienced a similar situation at Mono Lake.
At Mono Lake, Los Angeles was draining the lake essentially by taking the streams that went into the lake and diverting them into the city's water supply. And the environmental movement and the local residents in the Mono Basin and the Owens Valley convinced the world, really, that it was good to save Mono Lake and still supply Los Angeles with water by using reclaimed water and water conservation. We at Restore Hetch Hetchy have the same kind of challenge, and we have to have a similar plan that will explain to people that you can restore the Hetch Hetchy Valley and still have a total water supply, and I think we can do that.
We can only imagine if that water was drained and the forests and meadows returned to their natural beauty, we would have basically a second Yosemite, and it would be an outstanding place that people would come from all over the world just to see that part of Yosemite, much less Yosemite Valley.
A restoration committee of Restore Hetch Hetchy is looking at the possibilities for habitat restoration in the valley, and in order to do that, we will be studying the surrounding valleys and the surrounding habitats to see what would be feasible and what's existing and possibly what historically was there. That would be the, I guess, the ultimate goal is to bring back the historical habitats in the valley.
Restore Hetch Hetchy is working to bring about a publicly funded feasibility study that would build on the study done by Interior Secretary Hodel and on the substantial work that has been completed by the engineering team of Restore Hetch Hetchy.
If the question is, where do you go from here? It seems to me it's still necessary to have a study. You need to know what the predictions are as to what will happen. You've got to be able to show San Francisco it won't lose its water, it can get its power replaced. I believe that's what a study will show.
So we're advocating a feasibility study be done, publicly funded, independent of Restore Hetch Hetchy, independent of the city of San Francisco, independent of the federal government or the state of California. And we want the feasibility study to demonstrate how it can be done, how this win-win outcome can be obtained.
I think that you could fund the removal of Hetch Hetchy Dam with a public campaign. It wouldn't require any federal money. It's like the restoration of the Statue of Liberty. That was done with public funds, not with taxpayers' money, and it was a great project.
Just think how many people have missed strolling in the meadows and pastures, camping along my riverbanks, and experiencing this rare gift of nature. But still, Hetch Hetchy Valley is blessed. If restoration begins soon, over time we can expect the valley to return to its splendor. And I, Tuolumne, can return to my ancient way of being, bringing water to both Yosemite National Park and the people of California. Imagine the opportunity we have to allow nature to recreate another Yosemite Valley. There is no other opportunity like this anywhere else on Earth. Thank you.